If you need to brainstorm together as a team, explain something complex during an online class, or if you simply want to make your meetings more fun and interactive, then whiteboards are great. Let's look at how to set one up during a live session. Click on the Share button, Embedded Tool, Whiteboard. I want a blank whiteboard, so I'm going to create a new one. And in a few seconds, my whiteboard will appear on screen. I can decide if I would like my participants to be able to write and draw on the whiteboard too, so then it needs to be set to collaborative. Or if I want them to just watch whilst I explain something, then I'll need to toggle this off. And here, I can set my view mode. I quite like seeing my participants, so I'll set it to audience mode. Here you'll see all the tools you can use on your whiteboard. You can write, draw shapes, arrows, import pictures, erase something, etc. And over here you can change some settings and you can export your whiteboard if you need to. When you are done, you can click on Stop Sharing in the bottom left corner of your screen and the whiteboard will go away. If you need to see this whiteboard again after your session has ended, then you can easily find it in memory. Click on the relevant session and you'll see your whiteboard there. You can also download it from here if you need to. Okay, this is great, but what if you need a set whiteboard template that you can quickly and easily pull up when you need it? Then there's a slightly different way of doing things. From Sessions Home, go to Tools on the main menu. Look for Whiteboard by Sessions. Click on New Whiteboard, and a new whiteboard will open up so you can now prepare your template. Once you are ready, you can click back and your whiteboard will automatically be saved. You can also give it a new name if you like. You'll see that you have the option to choose what type of whiteboard you want, board or template. If you choose template, then the template you created will show up clean every time you load the board in a new meeting. So if you, for example, teach multiple classes and you want to start on a clean slate with every new group, then this is a good option. Note that memory will not be affected by this session. You'll still be able to revisit the board's content after your session has ended. On the other hand, if you choose board, the changes made during a session will be saved. So for example, if you need to brainstorm or explain something over multiple sessions and you don't want to lose your progress, choose board. Now let's go back into a live session. I'll click on Share, Embedded Tool, Whiteboard, and my template will now show up on the list and I can load it on screen. Last but not least, you can of course also add a blank whiteboard or one of your whiteboard templates to an agenda. Then when you click on the relevant agenda item during a live meeting, the board will automatically load on screen. When you're done, simply click on the next agenda item. And that's how to use whiteboards in sessions. Happy brainstorming!